Make local dev great with Lando. I'm Aaron Feledy. I own a one-man company called Arrow One Solutions, where I basically help my clients with anything Drupal related, from operations to back-end development, front-end development, maintenance, anything they need, pretty much. And I'm here today to talk about Lando. No, not that Lando. Not that Lando. This one. There we go. Lando. So Lando is for local development. And I'm going to talk about some of the current solutions prior to Lando. Once upon a time, and actually I still run into this from time to time, people have been running in-house development servers, and the developers either terminal in and they do all their coding in Vim, or they're uploading via FTP, or having to do a git pull, git push and git pull every time they make a code change just to see how it renders, which is cumbersome, and the whole process is bad for collaboration because one person's working on a file and maybe someone else decides to FTP their changes up and overwrite everything the other guy did. So you have all kinds of fun stuff like that. So obviously that's kind of a difficult way to go about things, so you probably prefer to be able to check things out locally on your own machine and render them and see how they work. Your native solutions, basically you install Apache on your laptop, you install MySQL, PHP on your laptop, and you run them. And your laptop basically is the web server. That's kind of difficult to, if you need to change things, configure things. If you have a team, different members of your team are going to deal with probably different configurations. If they're running Mac or Linux or Windows, you're going to have even more differences. So that was solved with some of that was solved with integrated packages, your WAMP, your MAMP, your XAMPP, Acquia Dev Desktop. It kind of made it easy to install these packages, and the configurations were kind of done for you, so you just basically run the installer and everything's going to be up and running. And that's still great, but you still have problems with different configurations, different environments, different users. So then we got into virtual machines. Things like VMware and VirtualBox, you could use those. You could have multiple server instances running at a time, so you're not just locked into whatever your machine can run. You can work on different projects with different setups. You can closely mimic your production environment. You can make images and share them with your team, and make snapshots along the way. Configuration with that, pretty cumbersome because you're basically building out a new server for each one of these, so you can automate that some with tools like Vagrant, Puppet, Ansible. There's Drupal VM, which leverages all of the above to build out a server. But again, it can be difficult to configure initially. VMs, especially if you're running more than one at a time, can be quite resource intensive. So then comes containers. Most of you have probably heard of Docker. Docker containers allow you to do a mix and match configuration of your environment, basically. Everything's pre-built into super lightweight packages. So if you want a certain Apache version and a certain MySQL version, and you want Drush, these can be prepackaged in containers, put together, and they all just run together. and Docker is cross-platform. You can use these containers to closely mimic your production environment. You can run multiple server instances at the same time within a single Docker VM. And you can make these, you can put these together in a Docker Compose file that you can share with your team so that everybody kind of builds the same environment. So now we're on to Lando again. This Lando. What is Lando? Lando is a free open source cross-platform local development and DevOps tool. It's essentially a wrapper for your entire development stack. You can use it to easily mimic your production environment. You can standardize your environments and tooling across all the developers on your team, across the different systems that they might be using. It integrates with hosting providers like Pantheon. It gives you tools to pull your database down and push up to if you really want to do that scary thing. And kind of just does these things with simple commands all automatically. It stores all of your configuration in a single file that you can put in version control and, again, share with your team. You easily customize or extend your tooling deployments. Yeah, you can easily customize it, basically. Your commands that you need to execute, the versions of various services that you need, they're all in the single config file. All very easy to update, share, whatever you need to do. Lando also gives you pre-built start states, essentially pre-configured environments. They call them recipes. You can initiate a Drupal 8 recipe, for example, and it gives you the pre-configured environment, all the services, all the right versions of everything that you need to run Drupal 8. The various other pieces of software, Joomla, WordPress, or just a simple LAMP stack. You can even roll your own. Start in any of these base languages. You've got .NET, Go, Node, PHP, Python, Ruby, it supports all of them. You have your base languages here. That's wrong title on that slide. That should be services. These are your services that are pre-built into Lando. You just put a single line in your config, then it will switch these on for you, whichever ones you need. You want to add phpmyadmin for your local dev, you just basically add one line to your config, and you have it, and it works. Here's an example of a Lando config file. It's a YAML file. This lives in the root of your project directory. And in this example, we've got the name of the project, Drupal Test. It's using the Drupal 8 recipe, so it's going to have all the correct versions of all the different services that you need already in there, so you don't have to define them. But in this particular example, what I've done is I've said in the config, I want the web root to be the actual root directory of the project. I want to run PHP version 7.0, because that's what I'm running on production. But since I'm local and I want to do some debugging, I'd say xdebug true, and it'll turn it on and configure it automatically for me. And in this case, I didn't want to use a local host kind of URL. I wanted to define phpmyadmin.drupaltest.lando.site to be the URL that I go to for phpmyadmin. And then services, it's actually where I say, okay, I want this phpmyadmin installed, and I'm calling it phpmyadmin, and it is of type phpmyadmin. So Lando will configure it and call it that. And I'm also saying I want a service called database, and it's typed to be MySQL 5.7, and it'll build that out for me. And then you can do some more advanced tooling if you like. You want to basically define your own commands to execute some functions that you might typically do against your code base. You could have, in this case, got a lemp stack all pre-built from a recipe. And I'm defining services. This one, it's in the app server's container, so that's where Apache would be running. And I tell it to run that particular command, composer install. So let's say I've got a composer file installed, composer or composer JSON in there, and I want to, you know, fill up my vendors directory and install everything after I pull down my code. During the build process, it will execute that automatically for me. So I can git pull, get my code, it will automatically do composer install, build out everything automatically. And then I want a, let's say I've also got in that code base a linter or some other test software that I want to execute against easily. I can, in my tooling, define my own commands. So Lando's command line based. So your commands, like you have Lando start to start everything up. I want to define my own command called Lando test. And what it will do is it will, on the app server, run composer test. So if I have a composer test that could be run, I just type Lando test and it will run it for me. And you can do this to execute CI tasks or anything else that you need. And then I'm going to break the big rule of presentations and I'm going to do it live. All right, and this is a brand new laptop that I've not had a chance to test, so high probability of failure. So, all right.
What can go wrong?
Oh, we still see that. Okay, I'll get that to go away. So what I've done here is I've got a directory called a demo. Inside of it, I have, I need to fix that. Inside of it, I have a folder called docroot. So maybe that's just the directory on the server, and I pulled that down, and now I have it locally in my project. And in this particular case, I have downloaded a fresh copy of Drupal 8 from Drupal.org and extracted it into that directory. And so now we're going to say demo is the root of my project, even though Drupal lives in the docroot directory. And if we want to start using this particular project with Lando, all we have to do is say Lando init, and it will ask me if I want to use a recipe. And in this case, I do. I want to use a Drupal 8 recipe. Make things easy for myself. My web root is called docroot. We're going to do it. What did I call this? Actually, Drupal test. We're going to call this Drupal test. And what it has done is given us a .lando.yaml file in our project directory that we can look at. It's automatically put in to find the name for me, the recipe, and the configuration that it's in the Docker directory. Let's say I want to make some more changes to that because I'm running different versions of things. This is essentially the same YAML file I showed you earlier. I'm actually going to copy that into... Yeah, sorry everyone, I'm using Windows. I'm not sure if anyone understands what I'm doing. Alright, so this is the file that was just generated. I'm going to go ahead and swap it out. And just add in some additional things here. Defining my PHP 7, xdebug's on, my PHP admin's going to be there running MySQL 5.7. Save that. So now, it's all in there. I just have to say Lando start. And what it's going to do, typically what it would do is download these containers for, these Docker containers for the various services, but I've actually already cached them ahead of time. So that went quick. It might take a minute if you have to download them. So what it did was it took all those containers, put them together, and launched them for me, and then gave me some URLs. It handles the routing for you. Something that might be a bit more of a manual task if you're just working with Docker. So I want to launch this Drupal test. And it has found my Drupal code base and loaded it for me.
How does it deal with the database?
So, how do you mean?
Just create a database in the backend for you to connect to, user and password, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, so the Drupal, you can define these yourself if you're rolling your own, but the Drupal 8 recipe actually defines all that configuration for you. So what it's doing is it's, in this particular case, it would define the database. The name of it is Drupal 8, the username is Drupal 8, and the password is Drupal 8. But you can actually go into your YAML file, change that to something else, or use it however you like to do.
Another question. It starts up all these services on different ports and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Can you go start up another Lando thing
yes.
at the same time?
And Lando is smart, too. It will... So right now I'm bound to port 80, so I can just go to this drupaltest.lando.site, and it's not localhost the port number like you might normally have to do. But say you do have Apache installed locally on your laptop and it's tying up port 80, Lando will take a look at that and go, okay, port 80 is used up, and it will define, it's got a list that it'll go through and try to find one that's open. It might be 8080 or something like that. It does that for all of its services. You can actually Lando info. It's not pretty, but you get a JSON output of the services and if they're which ports they're using. Things like that, URLs that they've bound to different services. On this one I've got phpmyadmin. So it created the Drupal 8 database for me. I haven't installed anything here yet, but say this was already a Drupal site that I had built, I can now say you're just used to using phpmyadmin to import your database. You can just use this tool, import your database, and now you're up and running. Lando also gives you a db import command. really have a demo of that, but basically, if you've got a gzipped backup of your database and you want to import it, you just type Lando db import, the name of the file, and it will load that into that MySQL database for you. And it supports like Postgres and the other services as well. If you just type Lando, you get all the commands you can execute. This recipe comes with Composer, Drush, Drupal Console. These are all pre-built in, they all just work for you. And you also have the ability, if Lando MySQL will drop you into a MySQL console, Lando PHP will run your commands against the app server. Share is pretty cool. If you work in an environment with a strict IT policy, they might not like you much, but they will. It allows you to actually host your local dev out to the network. Lando SSH, you can actually SSH directly into the containers. If you need to do any manual inside. Also DB export, I'll let you export your database. Those are the main ones you use. Lando list, if you have lots of Lando projects. Yeah, I work with a lot of different clients, and Lando is great for me because I can spin up or shut down all these different environments just as fast as you saw me do it. I just drop that in YAML config into their code base, so whenever I need to come back to their project, I just Lando start, builds back up for me, quick as that. And I, like I mentioned earlier, you can run multiple at a time. Eight sites running if I want. And that's about all I've got for you today. Any other questions?
How do you push the live site? I mean, you push the whole container from dev to live?
So you'd still use your classic methods. You either code would be git or FTP or whatever. And you'd still manually import. There is the Pantheon integration that's built in. That gives you, that's kind of cool, especially if you're just a single developer and you want to be able to just work locally and push everything up to production without having to touch anything. You just do Lando push is the command. And it pushes the whole thing up, Pantheon, for you. And Lando can be extended with plugins, so if other hosting providers wanted to add that functionality, or you wanted to build it yourself for your own development environment or your own production environment, you could do that. I've done that.
Otherwise, you would just like FTP the whole like that container, and you're running Lando on your live server,
right?
Or something that's running Docker.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Whatever your environment is, yeah. Push up your code, push up your database. If you probably wouldn't push up your database for production unless it was a very small site, but.
So right now we're running Docker in production, and we just pull those containers right down to dev on our locals. What do you see are the advantages of Lando over doing it like that?
Just the fact that it kind of wraps everything together and gives you all these tools built in, and being able to share it with your team. And it's also, Lando, since it is Docker-based, it does allow you to define your own container. So if you want to use your own and have them wrapped with Lando, you can.
Cool.
You jumped up first.
We use Docker base over the phone, and we use like the WadD Docker Drupal and then run Docker compose commands. But I'm interested in Lando because it'd be like, I guess it's less maintainable. Those Docker compose commands can be long, and for people who aren't as familiar, I don't have a lot of tools out of the box. How does it, I'm trying to figure out like differences in like in Travis, when we're running our builds in Travis, you know, because we have our Docker compose file and then, you know, in our Travis install, we pull and everything like that. Is it easy to integrate that with Lando as well?
Yep. Yeah, you can, like, that build step where I showed you in that example, or that tooling. You can add your own commands to run those commands from within Lando. You just define your own command, essentially, your own alias, I guess. And then, again, you can automate those, too. You want those, you can define them, and then you can say, I want these to run every time someone runs a Lando start and this environment's built. You have it run all of your stuff to maybe pull down your database and import your latest files, things like that.
In the YAML file there, you add onto the PHP the options of starting up or including xdebug. Are there any other extensions that it knows about or that it supports?
Yeah, so the I believe that was on the services. Yeah, this one should have been called services. For reference.
I'm sorry, I meant more specifically PHP extensions.
Oh, okay.
So clearly it knows about xdebug, but there are other
right.
things that you can turn off.
Xdebug wasn't listed in here. As far as built in, I think xdebug is one of the only ones that are built in. But you can have build steps to install any others that you need.
You can set it up so it runs like sudo apt-get. You have to have it has to be declared a certain way to run as like sudo.
Okay.
But I've actually had issues with that. I couldn't get curl actually working. That was kind of like one of my challenges with it. I still haven't got it worked out.
Yeah, and the Lando docs are actually very good. They're actually in the source code for the Lando project. The docs are included, and they don't accept any new features or changes without documentation commits as well. So all of their docs are up to date, and they're all thorough. And if you really want to get into Lando, the cool stuff you can do, you go to their site and pull up the docs, and there's a lot there. Yep.
So just to clarify, in terms of like sharing with teammates, is it through just like the one YAML file for
mm-hmm.
everything to find there? So as long as they have Lando and that
yep.
file, they can get this file.
Yep. And if you commit it to like your
databases or something like that, but I've been
fine. Right, yeah, you'd still need that. But as far as getting the environment spun up,
yeah.
It's all there, and then I've scripted the database pull of the latest backup into the so the first time they build it pulls in the latest database backup for them.
So I don't know if you can show an example of that. Like, is that like you would define that in that YAML file, like on the build step, like you're talking about, like to, or can you have like incremental things? You can like run some kind of custom Lando command to like refresh your local database.
Yes. What I've done is I built a series of scripts. I guess I could pull those up. They were more Drupal 7 focused because I was working on some Drupal 7 projects at the time. I've got them up on GitHub. Essentially, just a series of scripts. So you do I defined in the tooling a Lando script command that fires off this Lando script, which gives you the ability to then execute any of these other scripts that I've defined here. So I can do Lando script pull database, and it'll execute this script where I actually upload another script to the server to run a DB dump for this particular case. Probably not the best way to go about it, but it worked for this particular project. But does a DB dump, script pulls it down, runs the import, and all just from that one Lando command.
Okay.
And I did these as scripts, but Lando, it's pluggable, so you can make your own plugins to get even more advanced and really kind of work with Lando, control its output and everything. Change its behavior if you want.
For Lando init, does that have to be run on like a fresh download, or can you do that on a site you already started making changes to?
It's mainly to get started, fresh site. You wouldn't need to run that again once you.
But if you had a site you've already started messing with outside of,
right, you just want to you want to just get it up and running. Yeah, Lando init, just a quick way. Just there was only a few entries in the Drupal recipe, but some of the other ones have more entries that'll be put in there, but Drupal's pretty, like, internally, it supports Drupal well. So you just call it Drupal, and that's all it needs to put in command, the config. Anything else? Anybody else? All right, cool. Thank you.